Hello, I'm Holly Mangrum Willis. In this Tech Talk, I'll be discussing the definition of a strength as defined in appraisal findings. I'll explain what constitutes a strength and provide some examples of gratuitous strengths that should be avoided. The CMMI model defines a strength as a type of preliminary or final finding, which is an exemplary or noteworthy implementation of a process that meets the intent and value of a CMMI model practice. In other words, a strength finding must exceed what the model is asking for. In practice, it's difficult to get a strength because the model practices are comprehensive. This means that strengths are rare and not the norm. In the scope of a single appraisal, it's highly unlikely that every practice area would have a strength associated with it. While some lead appraisers want to use findings to provide value for the appraised organization, they should refrain from using gratuitous strengths to do this, as it can give the organization a skewed view of their process and performance improvement implementation. Let's look at several real examples of gratuitous strengths that have been submitted to ISACA. I'll explain what makes each strength gratuitous. Strength. The organization has automated their CM process. The CMMI model identifies what needs to be done, but not how. Simply automating a process isn't a strength. That could mean automating a bad process. Let's look at a gratuitous strength from the planning practice area. Integrated project plans are established. Plan 3.2 has integrate or develop plans clearly listed as an example activity. The way this strength is written just restates what is already in the model and therefore wouldn't be considered a strength. Our next example involves estimating. Project estimation processes and guidelines are very comprehensive in covering all the estimating practices. The strength is defined as a process that covers all the estimating practices. Simply covering all the CMMI model practices is not an exemplary or noteworthy implementation. That's only doing what the model requires and nothing else. Now that we've seen some examples of what makes a strength gratuitous, let's look at some more examples and discuss how an actual strength should look. The organization conducts really good peer reviews. PR 2.1 states, develop and keep updated procedures and supporting materials used to prepare for and perform peer reviews. Using established procedures and criteria for peer reviews results in a good peer review. There's nothing in this statement that identifies why it exceeds what the model practice is asking for. So it's not a strength as written. One way this could be an actual strength is if it looks something like this. The organization does several different types of peer reviews to check work. The peer review of live work on the manufacturing floor allows for real-time, almost instant correction of any issues identified. This is a better example of a strength as it goes beyond what the model is asking for while explaining the additional benefits and value that the organizational unit is seeing from their processes. Here's another example. Comprehensive CM process and guidelines have been established. This is a bad strength as written because the finding statement gives no details about why it is comprehensive. A better finding might be, the configuration management practices are thorough and comprehensive, covering version control, configuration items, configuration and change management system, baselines, configuration records, and audits across all projects and support functions. This example provides details on how the configuration management process is comprehensive and goes above and beyond from what the model says. Now let's look at an example of a gratuitous strength from the organizational training practice area. Overall, comprehensive strategic and annual plans are established. As written, this defines exactly what the OT 3.1 practice asks for. And again, it doesn't explain why the plans are comprehensive. Here's a better way to turn it into an actual strength. Short-term training needs are defined in the strategic plan and training plan. All trainings are aligned to specific strategic goals, and they can be bidirectionally traced from the strategic plan, training calendar, the training plan, and to the skills needed to accomplish the work. I hope that looking at several different gratuitous strengths has helped shed some light on what one is and how to identify it. True strength should have the following characteristics. The process exceeds what the model practice is asking for. There is supporting detail in the strength to explain why it is an exemplary or noteworthy implementation. The process is very effective. The process is consistently used and followed and yields repeatable results. The process is reflective of how the value statements in the model are effectively and efficiently met or exceeded. Remember, if there is a weakness in a practice area, it's unlikely there would also be a strength, as the process may have inefficiencies or isn't used or followed consistently. Thank you for joining me for this Tech Talk. If you have any additional questions, please get in touch with us at support.isaca.org.